हेलो वर्ल्ड, इट्स राहुल। वेलकम बैक गाइस टू मशीन लर्निंग ट्यूटोरियल। सो गाइस, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड बेसिक इंट्यूशन ऑफ एंट्रोपी, जीन इम्प्योरिटी, इंफॉर्मेशन गेन एंड सेलेक्शन ऑफ बेस्ट स्प्लिट इन लास्ट वीडियो। इफ यू हैवंट वॉच्ड दैट येट, प्लीज गो एंड वॉच। आई हैव अटैच्ड द लिंक इनटू द डिस्क्रिप्शन। सो गाइस, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हाउ कैन वी सॉल्व क्लासिफिकेशन प्रॉब्लम यूजिंग डिसीजन ट्री एल्गोरिथम। सो गाइस, हियर आई एम यूजिंग वेरी फेमस डेटा सेट as you can see on the screen. So we have 5 columns in which outlook, temperature, humidity and windy are categorized as input feature, whereas play golf categorizes as output. So guys, here we have different weather conditions and we have to predict whether one should go outside to play golf or not. Let's see how we will proceed towards such problem. So here we will be going to use ID3 algorithm for building decision tree. So first, let's count number of yes and number of no for output column, that is play golf. And here we have 5 no's and 9 yes. So we will calculate entropy for target variable. So formula for entropy is sigma of minus pi log of pi. Guys, this we have already seen in last video. Let's substitute the value of yes and no in equation as shown on the screen. So we will get entropy for play golf as 0.94. Once we are ready with the entropy of target variable, we will find out the entropy for each column with respect to target variable to find the most homogeneous sample. Let's extract the outlook column from original data set. So here we can see that sunny has 3 yes, 2 no, overcast has 4 yes, 0 no, and rainy has 2 yes and 3 no. Now we can calculate the entropy for each value of outlook column. Let's find out the entropy of sunny, which is having 3 yes and 2 no. So probability of yes will be number of yes over sum of number of yes and no. So here 3 over 3 plus 2 into log of 3 over 3 plus 2 minus 2 over 2 plus 3 into log of 2 over 2 plus 3 is equal to 0.971. Same we will do for overcast and rainy and get entropy as 0.971 for rainy and 0 for overcast. Guys, I have told you in last video that if we have either yes or no at leaf node, then that will be categorized as pure subset and entropy for that will be 0. That's why here entropy for overcast is 0, as overcast has only yes component. So once we are ready with entropy for each value in outlook column, we will find out the entropy for complete output column with respect to play golf column. And this will be calculated as probability of sunny into entropy of sunny plus probability of overcast into entropy of overcast plus probability of rainy into entropy of rainy. So guys, here probability will be assigned as number of value over total number of items in outlook column. So we have 5 sunny in outlook column, so probability of sunny will be 5 over 14. In the same way, probability of overcast will be 4 over 14 as we have 4 overcast values in outlook column, and probability of rainy will be 5 over 14 as outlook has 4 rainy. Let's substitute the values in equation so that we can get the entropy for outlook column as 0.693. Now let's calculate entropy for temp column. So guys, I'm going to show you each and every steps by solving it here only, so that you will understand the topic thoroughly. Alright, so again, we will extract the temp column from original table as you can see on the screen. So temp has 3 values, hot, mild and cold. Let's quickly jump into hot and try to find out the entropy. But before that, hot has 2 yes and 2 no. So guys, I have already told you in last video that if we have same number of yes and no component with us, then entropy would always be 1. So for hot, entropy will be 1. If you want, I can show you as well for more clarity. So entropy is equal to 2 over 2 plus 2, as we have to find probability of yes, and that will be number of yes over sum of number of yes and no. So 2 over 4 into log of 2 over 4 minus 2 over 4 into log of 2 over 4. So here first term will come up as 0.5 and second term will also come up as 0.5. So adding both will give us 1. Okay, let's find out entropy for mild. So mild has 4 yes and 2 no. So entropy will be 4 over 6 into log of 4 over 6 minus 2 over 6 into log of 2 over 6. So 0.39 plus 0.53 would be 0.92. Now cool has 3 yes and 1 no. So entropy for cool will be 3 over 4 into log of 3 over 4 minus 1 over 4 into log of 1 over 4. And this will be equated as 0.81. So we have calculated entropy for each value of column temp. Now we'll calculate the entropy for complete temp column. And that will be probability of hot into entropy of hot plus probability of mild into entropy of mild plus probability of cool into entropy of cool. So we can write it as 4 over 14 into 1 as hot as 4 values and 1 as entropy plus 6 over 14 into 0.92 plus 4 over 14 into 0.81. So this will be equated as 0.90. So guys, entropy for temp column will be 0.90. Now column humidity as shown on the screen. So humidity has two values, high and normal. Let's find out entropy for high, which is having 3 yes and 4 no. So entropy for this will be calculated as 3 over 7 into log of 3 over 7 minus 4 over 7 into log of 4 over 7. So we have entropy for high as 0.99. Same we can find for normal, which is having 6 yes and 1 no. And this will be calculated as 6 over 7 into log of 6 over 7 minus 1 over 7 into log of 1 over 7. So entropy for normal would be 0.60. Now let's calculate entropy for complete humidity column as probability of high into entropy of high plus probability of normal into entropy of normal, and this will be equal to 7 over 14 into 0.99 plus 7 over 14 into 0.60. Hence, we will get entropy for humidity as 0.795. So guys, we are only left with windy column. Let's quickly calculate the entropy for this as well. So here, windy has false and true values, where false has 6 yes and 2 no, and true has 3 yes, 3 no. So entropy for false will be 6 over 8 into log of 6 over 8 minus 2 over 8 into log of 2 over 8. And this will be calculated as 0.81. Let's calculate entropy for true as well. So guys, you can see that true has equal number of yes and no component. So entropy for this will definitely be 1. Now let's calculate entropy for complete windy column, and that will be calculated as probability of false into entropy of false plus probability of true into entropy of true. So 8 over 14 into 0.81 plus 6 over 14 into 1. So entropy for windy column will be 0.88. So guys, as we have calculated the entropy for each value in each column with respect to target variable as shown on the screen, now we have to find out the information gain, as the information gain is based on the decrease in entropy after a dataset is split on an attribute. Constructing a decision tree is all about finding attribute that returns the highest information gain. So now, resulting entropy for each column will be subtracted from the entropy before the split. So gain for outlook column will be calculated as entropy of play golf column, that is nothing but our target variable, minus entropy of outlook column with respect to play golf column. So 0.94 minus 0.693 will be 0.247. Same we will do with each input column and get information gain for each column as shown on the screen. So guys, I told you just now that our information gain should be high. So in this case, we will select the attribute or column that is having the highest information gain. And we can say that Outlook column has the highest information gain. So now we will divide the data set by its branches and repeat the same process on every branch. Guys, one thing to note here is that a branch with entropy of 0 will always be a leaf node, but branch with entropy of more than 0 needs further splitting. So if you can see, Overcast has 4 yes and 0 no. So we can create a leaf node at Overcast with the value play golf as yes. Now we only have to look at sunny and rainy for outlook column. So let's see how can we split sunny. So we have a table shown on the screen. Now we have to repeat the same process for finding out the entropy for each columns. Let's calculate entropy for temp column, which is having mild and cool values. And mild has 2 yes, 1 no, and cool has 1 yes, 1 no. So entropy for cool will be 1, as count of both yes and no are same. And entropy for mild will be 2 over 3 into log of 2 over 3 minus 1 over 3 into log of 1 over 3 equal to 0.92. So entropy for temp will be calculated as 3 over 5 into 0.92 plus 2 over 5 into 1, and this will be equal to 0.95. So we will find out the entropy for humidity and windy by same mean. So entropy for humidity will be 0.95 and entropy for windy will be 0, as false has only yes component whereas true has only no component. Now we will calculate information gain for each column, and that will be equated as information for temp will be 0.96 minus 0.92 equal to 0.04. Information gain for humidity will be 0.04. And information gain for windy will be 0.96, as 0.96 minus 0 will be 0.96 only. So as we can see, windy has the highest information gain among 3 columns. So we will add windy as node below sunny and split the windy column now. Windy has false and true value, and false has 3 yes, 0 no, and true has 0 yes, 2 no. So we can split this on false and true and add it as leaf node. Same thing we will repeat with rainy for finding out the split. So guys, I want to share one trick over here so that you will not have to calculate every time. If you can see the table for rainy, then you will be able to visualize that humidity has high and normal value, and again high has 3 no, 0 yes, and normal has 2 yes, 0 no. So entropy for this column will always be 0. And if you have a look on other column, then you will find out that other column has mixed data. So information gain will be high for humidity column, as this column has 0 entropy value. So now we can split on the humidity just by looking into the table, and our leaf node will be high and normal with value yes and no. So guys, now we have built the decision tree on this dataset. By having this knowledge, we can construct decision tree on any of the dataset. One more thing to add here is that by looking into this decision tree, we can create decision rules as well as shown on the screen. So I will suggest you to pause the video and have a look into decision rule. This is nothing but the if-then statement made by decision tree. So guys, in next video, we will see how can we solve regression problem and construct decision tree using ID3 algorithm. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.